back to the action of this exhibition match between Olivia Areano and Mickie James, with the respective do-or-die opponents here spectating on ringside here. If you just joined us, you basically missed how the World's Hottest Tag Team with a cheap-ass beatdown with a steel chair on Mickie James just rolling through. It's coming down here during her entrance. And how Mickie James is still competing here tonight is a mystery to us. And we see Mona Loca already on the outside. We all know she's going to be facing Mickie James for the Double X Championship. It's going to be do or die for Mickie James, because if Mickie James loses, not only is she losing an opportunity to win the Double X Championship, you know, she's going to lose her roster spot here in the UWA, and it might be resorted to nothing but a job or only making house show appearances. Oh, look at that! Tremendous drop by Olivia Areano. Olivia perhaps one of the ultimate great offensive maneuvers here in UWA. One of those fast-paced competitors here. Look at this. Let's roll up the senton pin here. Only a two count. I don't know what Ross Mitchell's decision is to, you know, to force Mickie James to win or... Mickie James going back to town on Olivia Areano here. I don't know if that whole talk with Ross Ritter Mitchell over time might have been motivation in this matchup here. Look at this! And once again, they fall for it like they always do. It was a huge hurricane rondo, Olivia Areano. And this could be the end for Olivia Areano. Uh-oh, this kick to the gut. No, this means this huge tornado DDT here. Well, look at the setup. Oh my god, did you see? Olivia has a broken neck. She has a broken neck.
What a huge upset this would be if Mickie James could pull off a victory after the premeditated strike she took before this match even started. And, oh man, just moments away, you saw how
Olivia's neck was contorted upon impact by that tornado DDT, and I still don't know how the hell Olivia was able to kick out of that. I don't know how the hell these double X's could keep going after all the offense they've been taking here tonight. They would come out and ditch out with moves like that. Oh, that's a huge moonsault. It's driving her knees right onto the back of Mickie James' head right there. And this is, look at this. I mean, Mickie James just cannot keep up with Olivia in this matchup. And like you pointed out in New Scene, after the attack that Mickie James took from World's Hottest Tag Team, I mean, Mickie James is not on the level that she normally competes at. We saw what she did at Pandemonium 10, where she survived both Anna 10 and Renegade Diva, despite all the blood that was spilt, all the tables that were broken, despite the interference from Jeff and Silverwolf, despite the career-shortening attacks in that match, Mickie James came out on top.
Listen, I beg to differ, Rock, because despite all the punishment she's taken so far, I think she's actually combating just fine. And look, she's got Olivia Areano on the ropes here, and she's had her down for that near fall. But right now, Olivia trying to come back. Mickie James gets shot in the corner. Maybe some payback. Oh, wait. Oh, look at... Oh, my God! Look at that! That arm drag! Mickie James definitely didn't see that coming. I didn't see that coming. Oh, my gosh. That backward moonsault. And the cover here hooks the leg. That can be right there. Mickie James gets a kick out. He's putting on a great display here for the crowd tonight. I hope he might have wasted some time there. Mickie James... saw it coming and trying to capitalize here with this bridging cover. It'll be all goodness. Who's going to walk out the victor here and getting the momentum going in the do or die? And what's Mickie James doing is dragging Olivia Areano. I'm not sure what she wanted to do. Olivia is trying to roll out the way and dodging Mickie James' attacks.
Has a store for Mickie James here. Oh, you know what happens when you see individuals in the corner. And then, oh, that really spider-driven suplex on Mickie James. Oh, there's another third moonsault. Nicely executed. The referee only had a two count there. And where's the Olivia going again? Oh, wait, oh, look at that freaking 900 corkscrew moonsault thing that she does. Huge move, it's a finisher. Look at Now, I don't know how the hell Mickie James was able to kick out after that. And Mama Loca getting involved herself. Trying to distract Mickie James or encourage her. One of the two. Oh, what the hell? Oh, I gotta say that damn real Arisea. That ring bell. Oh, no good. This Mickie James has no choice but to go for a pin attempt. And that's it, folks. Mickie James victorious after the involvement in the racist Arisea.
Here's your winner, Mickie James.
James. Win. He definitely needed it going into do or dies. And Mickie James needs all the momentum she can get from against the Mona Loco, and she knows that her spot, her livelihood here in UWA, could be in serious jeopardy on Saturday, July 3rd, at do or die from Philadelphia. Nina with Mona Loco and Mickie James compete. They're going to have a huge match. That's going to be easily anticipated. Look at the replay of this. This block of tornado DDT. Just watch how Olivia's neck is... Oh, man, her head, the cream has bounced right off the mat and just bends in the way it shouldn't. And then, I don't know how Olivia was able to come back with that 900 corkscrew elbow. Mona Loco, the distraction or either encouragement to Mona or to Mickie James. Loco distracted, allowing Arisea to come in with the ring bell. And allowing Mickie James to go for an easy three count. Referee Robert Sweeney holding Mickie James' hand as the victor. Folks, what's going to happen at Do or Die? Saturday, July 3rd in Philadelphia. Our next quick preview, our next mega quick preview after Pandemonium 10. Our first big CAW of the summer, the day before July, or July 3rd, the day before Independence Day from Philadelphia, one of the oldest and patriotic cities in America. Do or Die, folks, live Saturday, July 3rd. Oh, wait a minute, I don't remember this graphic being the Do or Die graphic. I was familiar with the Elimination Chamber graphic. What the hell is this Uncle Sam graphic doing? Ran this by me. Well, I guess the guys in the editing department kind of fucked this one up. But still, folks, live Saturday, July 3rd from Philadelphia's Do or Die next pit review. We have the street fight between Outlaw Star, Gene Starwin, and Jim Hawking. Take on the UWA Originals, Luke Fowler, and Ross River Mitchell, the GMs of UWA. In a street fight, and whoever wins will qualify, team will qualify to compete in the Elimination Chamber match for the Master Ring. And these teams have been fighting ever since the Swerve Despair. Finally, something will finally give, hopefully, at Do or Die. And of course, we just mentioned earlier, the real Arisea will take on Olivia Areano. Well, if Arisea loses, and gets to denounce her racist views and learn to embrace other races. But if Olivia loses, it'll definitely be Do or Die, because if she doesn't, show her papers that she's an American citizen, that she has to leave the UWA. Of course, this epic personal rivalry between Steve Hebert and the Destroyer will culminate at Do or Die. And it all started when the franchise player was ran down and was gone from the UWA after the Destroyer eliminated him at Pandemonium 10. Now his former best friend Steve Hebert will step up and make things right. And now the No Limits title will also be on the line. Vicious mandated defend his No Limits title in every single UWA show. We still don't know who his opponent will be. At this point, still a big question mark. Who will step up and will compete for the No Limits title at Do or Die against Big Vicious? And then, of course, it'll be a no disqualification match. The return match from Pandemonium. Vaughn Kreed from the Nation of Violence takes on Quinton Rampage Jackson. But this time, not just Nation of Violence members, but every individual will be barred from ringside to ensure what happened at Pandemonium does not take place at Do or Die to ensure a clean finish between these two rivals. And then they'll be for the Double X Championship as the Amazon Mona Loco, the current Double X Champion, takes on Mickie James, one half of the UWA Women's Tag Team Champions. And it's going to be Do or Die for Mona Loco, and especially for Mickie James, because her career will be in jeopardy if she fails to win the Double X Championship. Then, speaking of women, it's going to be the Women's Championship of the World as Angelina defends the gold against Stacey Hardy, Ursula Ariano, and Athena in a fatal four-way, one fall to a finish. I mean, these three, four doubles all qualified, all proved why they deserve a shot, and Ross Mitchell's going to give them the go-ahead. and all four will clash at Do or Die. And then for the mastering will be the Elimination Chamber match. So far we have three confirmed participants, Goman, Samoa Joe, and Spike, who will be the three participants to be competing over the final. We'll be watching Do or Die to find out who the three final participants are. And then of course in the main event is the UWA Championship. Planet X takes on Lord Magma. If there's any man that can stop the Nation of Violence, it is Planet X. Well, we saw Lord Magma in the last few weeks, the dominant man that he is, the Planet X WS is more cut out for him in the main event.